time to come through for you is the clutch. Last second, what a rush. Look, I'm the type to talk to the stars. Straight up, these ain't tattoos, these are scars. My young dogs will tell you when the witness is apart. They care about starving more than they do by the charge. Me, I can't break a commitment. I done seen people f*** up the whole team cause they couldn't play their position. Talking about dating meaning, but you know the road to hell was paved with good intentions. I see myself and my nemesis. I contemplate in forgiveness. I think I lost all my innocence. My life depend on this, this ain't no simple. Try stealing, you get beat, that's what you get. I feel safer taking risks and I can't eat this on my own life. Put my back against the wall just to see how much I grow, dog. I was raised by the wolves, ate to they fools. Running through the night, playing with your life. Go and get the pack, that's risk in your life. Better play it right, better play it right. I was raised by the wolves, ate to they fools. Running through the night, playing with your life. Go and get the pack, that's risk in your life. Better play it right.
On my wrist, ice in my veins, but it's a cold, cold world, and you could be predator, you could be prey. I was raised by the wolves, eight to the four, run through the night, playing with your life. Go against a pack that's risking your life.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday. Wiping off the sweat this Friday because I was running with the Wolves for about an hour and 15 prior to this call. Shirt is dripping. Welcome to the Morning Rush, your morning empowerment call for busy executives, heart-centered leaders out to cause the change that we want to see in the world. And today we're blessed with the Wolf Pack, the Wolves, and a wolf theme. I don't know how you feel about wolves, but I kind of like the emblem of it, the motif of it, the running with the wolves. I used to hear the slogan, if you want to run with the big dogs, you got to get off the porch. Well, if you want to run with the wolves, you got to get off the porch as well. And I'm going to welcome our good friends, Mariano and Christopher from the Wolfpack in just a moment. But I kind of want to intro what's going on here this week in terms of it's been a theme of community. Like, how do we build community? How do we build the wolf pack? You know, how do we build what we want around us as individuals, maybe? Like, what community do you want around you? And how do you attract it? How do you build it? We've talked about engagement. We've talked about contribution. We've talked about what kinds of elements do you want in your community? So that's what really we're looking to close this week strong with, is thinking about community. Like, thinking about the community we're building here on the Morning Rush and all the different ecosystem partnerships. When you think about ecosystem, it's the web of everything in our life. And like Heather is an example of an incredible ecosystem partner. If you haven't talked to Heather, I'd be surprised if you've been on the Morning Rush. Like, that's just how Heather shows up. And, you know, that's why Sammy pumps his hand when I said, think about Heather. Like, that's just what's going on here. And everybody probably has their own story one way or another. And the story today is really about Christopher and Mariano and what they've created. But Heather somehow connected with them and they somehow connected with us. And in essence, the Wolfpack is growing one way or another. And we're planning a little gathering on November 4th in Panama City. And that's all going to be talked about in the future. But let me bring in Christopher, Mariano. You guys showed up earlier this week a couple of times. How are you guys doing today?
Hello. Hey, very happy and excited to be here with you all this morning. You know, I've been coming regularly now, and I'm not usually a morning person in my history, right? But like, I'm enjoying and I'm looking forward to being on this call every day. So yes, I'm really happy to be here. So thanks for the introduction, David. I really appreciate all that highlight, and Heather as well for bringing us in and introducing us here. So
yeah,
for community.
I want to like ask a question just about like, because we're talking about community today, right? Like,
yeah.
And you guys, maybe tell a little bit. I'd love to tell you to tell your story from the sense of like building community, however that lands for you, and like what the value of community is, because I think that's what Wolfpack Brotherhood in some ways is really centered around. So, you know, over to you, whatever you'd like to share inside of that and what you guys are up to.
Sure, absolutely. So, you know, we started at zero, right? So like yesterday we had 10 guys from all over the area coming to the house and sitting at the round table, and like some of the best conversations and most vulnerable conversations you can have. And that's kind of the space that we hold for men. And we have, you know, we have certain techniques and everything, but as far as building community, you know, one of the things is like finding or developing a culture and alignment with each other. Like everyone here, this isn't the basket weaving club, right? You know, this is everyone. These are people with all like-minded, you know, thoughts and feelings of wanting to better themselves and grow and support each other and things of that nature, right? So like when we talk about community, first of all, is culture and alignment. You know, there's a bunch of other men's groups out there, and some of them are rough and tough and like, you know, let's go put on the boxing gloves and punch each other in the face and roll around in the sand. And some other men's groups are like, you know, let's grow out dreadlocks and smoke, you know, the grass on the beach all day, right? So there's different versions of that. And so our culture in our group is just, it's more refined. We're an inward journey, and it's more like a Knights of the Round Table brotherhood experience. And so that's kind of how we define our culture within our community. And you know, there's a book that I read, and I don't want to take up too much time, but it's a book I read by David Data. It's called Enlightened Sex. Okay. And it's not the point that I'm bringing up is not about sex, but it's about, in that book, he discusses energy. And there's three different types of energy. There's the I, me energy, right? There's a I do you, or I do me, you do you, you take care of your business, I take care of mine. And that's stage two. And then stage three is everything that we're doing is in the betterment of, or for the betterment of mankind. And that's stage three energy. So that's what we're trying to develop within our community, and find that within our communities, people like you, people like everyone here that are in this stage three, they're doing something to be part of something bigger than themselves. They want to better the world. They want to better their neighborhoods. They want to better their, you know, everything outside themselves. And it's not as much about me. And whenever you don't put the spotlight on you, you don't feel all the problems as much either, right? So, you know, we're helping people solve their problems. So that's stage three energy. Another thing is, you know, mutual beneficial relationships, right? If you're just giving out all of your energy and not getting anything back in return, that's not healthy as much as it is for you to just take and take and take and take. And we all know people like that. We've all experienced people like that. So we want to have mutual beneficial relationships within our community. And that's, I think, a key point. And last is, or not last, but there's two more. One is that we have key players in like leadership roles that people want to have a role. Whenever you assign someone an area of responsibility, they take ownership for it. So we have like group captains, and then they take ownership of their group. And then they have a lieutenant who takes ownership of his responsibility. And then we pass the torch in certain aspects within our community. And so that it can't all be on David all the time. Right. So that's where other people step in and pick up whenever you're not available or you have other things going on. Right. So it's aligning with key members in leadership positions in your community. Last but not least is exchanging your skills and services and sharing clients. So, you know, like I'm not trying to take all of your business and you're not trying to take all of mine. And I'm not trying to, like, I want to give you things and my services for free. In exchange for, you know, whatever experiences you are offering, I want to experience that as well, right? So we can exchange services, and also the people that you're already helping, let's bring those and exchange those people. Those clients of yours might need the services I have that I don't offer, or the services you have that I don't offer, and vice versa, right? So exchanging clients and services within your community, I think, is like a, you know, a great bartering system, and we can all share the fun. So that's the rundown. I sat yesterday and I was like, you challenged me with that. Yeah, like, you know, tomorrow's community. Okay, think about it. It's like, I have to really think about this now, you know? And so yeah. I was in the sauna coming up with all this information, and it's, I didn't Google it, or I didn't pull it from ChatGPT or whatever. I sat with it, and this is what we came up with. This is what I came up with personally. So thank you for having us on this morning.
Well, I think this is fun. I have so many different directions to go with this. I got some goosebumps. I wasn't sure if it was because I'm sopping wet and I just came into the AC, or I was just moved by everything you guys were saying. And then you said ChatGPT, and I saw Jen smile because I know she has a very tight relationship with ChatGPT right now. And that's, yeah, part of the challenge. And I love how you said it was a challenging question to come in today, because like, I think there's a challenge inside of building community, even for myself in this community and thinking about it, because, and I love your perspective on this, and this may be a tough kind of question as well, is like, how do we separate ego and attachment to outcome from really just creating a healthy and thriving contribution-oriented community? Because there is, like, if I'm honest with myself, sometimes I'm like, man, I wish the morning rush was 1,000 people deep and doing this and doing that. And some of that's not from contribution. It's like, that would be pretty cool to David, right? And I oftentimes check that and I say, how can I come in here and really be of contribution heart and mind and soul and create the safe space that has community thrive in a healthy way, not in like a egoic way or a codependent way? And like, some of those words have come up recently. So I'm just curious if you guys have either faced that or seen it, or you have a way that you really look to create a healthy, nourishing, flourishing environment versus one that might have more of the egoic, like dependent energy. You know what I'm saying?
I'll take it. No, I'll take that one. Thank you, Dave. I went through a lot of that when we started this, because when you're leading men, you know, there's a lot of people that come to you for questions, for answers, you know, and then your ego starts going like, ooh, I'm reaching like, you know, guru status. Everybody wants, you know, to give them answers. I feel like I'm movable. So I'm doing this to make my ego feel great that people come to me, you know, and that's when I realized, what am I doing here? You know, who the hell do I think I am? I'm just a mere mortal. I'm just human. I just might know a little more information than the people are coming into my group, you know? So what I had to face, the harsh truth is, I'm not here for me. I'm not here for you. I'm here for everybody. You know, why do I show up? Because I show up for something bigger that I don't understand what it is. I have no clue. But I'm here showing up for that to happen as the stage three, to create whatever it is that's being created. And, you know, sometimes we got to pay bills. And sometimes that gets challenging. Okay, I'm creating this thing that I don't know, but how am I going to pay my bills? You know, yeah. And that's when the doubt comes in, you know. But then on the other side of that, I look back at all the men that did show up, all the men that changed their lives by doing, you know, the steps that we do and the processes that we do. And I said, abundance is so great. I just got to get out of my own way to let it flow, you know? And then I meet people like Heather. I meet people like you. I met people like Ben. I met other brothers that are doing medicine around this area too. And it's like, they're all coming because I gave up. I surrendered to the ego of like, I need to have 1,000 men to feel like I am good and to show other people that my group is bigger than them. It's like, no, if we have 10 guys that are dedicated to life, and they're changing their life and they're really proud of who they are, I'm great with that, you know? And I will show up for who, if I have one guy, I'll show up for one guy, 10 guys or 100 guys.
Yeah. So
that's my take on the ego side. You just got to do it for something that's bigger than you. When you do that, they people feel that love, they feel your heart, and it just starts to grow organically.
Yeah. And I want to, I'm present to acknowledgement right now, because even when I first met you two, from presence on the call to the call afterwards, like that's what I was present to, was that you guys come from that heart-centered community contribution space. Like it's noticeable, it's palpable, and it's beautiful because it's what I think this community is all about as well. And sometimes it's a nice talking point, right? It makes sense. It resonates to say it, but then to show up that way. So I just wanted to reflect back to you brothers, that like, that's how you're showing up in the space and in the world. And, Heather wouldn't have connected us if that wasn't the case. So I'm going to hand it over. And normally everyone, if you're new to the call, we usually go into breakout rooms. We may do that briefly in just a little bit, but I think this is worth just talking in mass and group. And Heather, what say you? You know these men, what they're up to. You know the morning rush, what we're all up to. I'm just curious what's on your heart, mind, soul this morning.
Yeah, I mean, I think when you talk about creating community, you know, it's something that I've done in the past. And the first time I created my own yoga studio in Philly in the suburbs, I didn't even know that I was doing what I was doing. And so now 3 years later, and Dana can attest to that, it's like, I didn't realize the power and the magic that I was creating with my women's circle, and it was diverse. And we had some sprinklings of men, but we had a really powerful women's group, and we're still all super connected. And so now I got to move and got connected with another yoga studio, which is how I got to Christopher Mariano. But it was through the women. It was through my divine feminine sisterhood that I got to this brotherhood. My teacher, my yoga teacher, saw something in me. And she said, Maggie, if you want to do what you want to do, Heather's the only person I know doing what you're doing. And I take great honor and pride in that. And so for me, it's full circle because my growth and expansion is only because of David and the morning rush the past year. It's been my integration for my medicine, for my yoga. Tony Robbins, as you know, he's my rabbi. David's one of my other rabbis and my brother. I use that word because for me, David asked about creating community, and it's all about enlightenment is being a teacher and connecting with your teachers and then learning from your teachers and then being your own teacher. But I always say I like to be the cream in the middle of the Oreo. Like there's always a layer above me and a layer below me. I never want to be at the top of anything ever. I did it. I already own my own business. I already lived my dream. This is my second life now I'm stepping into. So like I get to be the cream and be like just the middle of the sandwich all the time where there's a business owner above me. I'm the cream. And then there's a layer that I get to then guide to help other systems. So I kind of manifest.
I just want to pause. I love that analogy. I was looking for a glass of milk and a tub of Oreos because I used to love that. And it is Fun Friday. So Heather, in fun energy, how do you eat your Oreos? Like what's, do you break it in half? Do you eat it with milk? Like what, like if you had your ideal scenario for eating your Oreo, like what do you like?
So intentionally this is such a divine feminine answer is number one, I would make my own now from scratch. Cause I wouldn't eat anything out of a bag or a container with chemicals in it. Number two, I would just stick the whole thing in the milk till it gets soggy and it's about to fall apart. And then like, I put my hand underneath. So just as it starts to crumble and it's like mushy pudding, that's when I eat it. But I haven't had Oreos in probably 10 years, but maybe we can make them at the men's retreats. Maybe we'll make some Oreos scratch.
I love it. What Heather, if there's one word that you would talk about Christopher Mariano and what they're doing, like what's the first word that like comes out of your heart and soul about these guys?
Powerful. Powerful.
I like that. That's beautiful. Heather, thank you for making these connections. We're going to go to Sammy now. Sammy, what's present for you, brother?
It's been said all, you know, Heather is just amazing. She mentions how in order that like her feminine attracted the masculine and the masculine attracts the feminine and they both support each other. It's beautiful. And I want to make that comparison with the ego. David, you mentioned, you know, when you think about 1,000 people joining the morning rush and how you balance that ego, right? Being a contribution versus, you know, this is what I want for my own self-edification from my ego, to channel Matt, your coach, it's unremarkable that your ego is going to show up. To Christopher and the Wolfpack.
Wait, say that. Sammy, say that again. Say that again, because it takes a little bit for everyone to really grasp what he just said. Like, it's unremarkable that your ego is going to show up. What does that mean, Sammy? Like, how would you describe that? Like, take a moment to think that through, because that's a little bit of a mind bender.
Yeah. So if your ego is not showing up, then you're not playing hard enough. If you're not face to face with your ego and your challenge and the thing that you want to overcome and the thing that you want to be the what so with, right? Like Landmark uses, the thing that you historically has blocked me from being, oh, just so spiritual and loving and everything. If that's not showing up on a daily basis, if the devil is not showing up to challenge me, then I'm not doing enough. Because the purpose of the ego is to help me understand and be a greater contribution. It's not to overstep it, it's not to dismiss it, it's not to fight it. It's to say, yes, I have an ego. That's one of my identities. But that's not all I am. I'm much more than myself. I'm much more than myself. I'm a part of something bigger than myself.
Yeah, take that in. It's unremarkable that your ego is going to show up, meaning like it's going to show up and like it's not going to be a surprise that it shows up, but it's how we kind of choose to act when it does show up and course correct if our true intention is what Mariano and Christopher are bringing forward here, which is like community. So Christopher, Mariano, back to you. I'm going to do a quick 5-minute like speed breakout, but I'm curious what's present for you in the conversation before we do that, and you know, what's coming alive maybe in this conversation for you guys?
I really don't know what's happening right now, to be honest. Like, I'm in this room full of people that I have no idea what they're going to be in, and this is my life. I keep jumping into this. I don't know what's happening because I surrendered to whatever it is that I need to do. I'm just showing up, that's all. And that's what happened, what's feeling for me right now. I'm so grateful to be here, waking up early in the morning, although I'm tired because we're up way late last night. And I'm very, very grateful for you, David, for doing this, you know, for the third stage, for everybody just to come in here and get to know each other.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. I love that. It's like there's sometimes the expression of what's happening doesn't have necessarily profound words. It's just like, I'm here now, I'm present and I'm showing up. And that's what I'm feeling right now. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to do a speed breakout room for 5 minutes, but it's going to be 2 or 3 people. So you might just be with one other person. And the prompt today is really like, what's coming up for you around community? What's coming up in this conversation? Share for a minute or two and then have the other person share. And let's have some fun. And then we'll wrap up. Maybe we'll get a Wolfpack countdown. And if anybody wants to stay after, we'll be here for another 15 minutes or so. I'm opening the rooms now and we'll see you all on the other side of the breakouts. Hello, brother. And Cinzia, how are we doing?
Hello, good morning, good morning. I'm late to the conversation. I only caught the last little bit, so give me a minute to catch up.
No problem. Nick, if you're there, do you want to open up the sharing and then Cinzia can jump in with whatever's present for her?
Sure. So I love today's conversation, you know, talking about, you know, just, you know, men's groups and women's groups and, you know, even blended groups as well, and just spaces for people to grow and develop and create masterminds and exchange ideas and just give different perspectives about how different things land, even just in conversation. So that's what's, you know, present for me today. I do have to keep it short as I'm walking into work here, but I'll be able to contribute as best I can.
I love it. I love it. Thank you, Nick. So Cynthia, just to give you a little backdrop on this conversation, Christopher and Mariano have a program called the Wolfpack Brotherhood. And this week on the Morning Rush, I don't know how much you're familiar with us. We've been talking about community and building community and how do you, you know, create a supportive atmosphere and a thriving, healthy environment. So I'm just curious how it all lands for you and who, how did you get connected to the Morning Rush?
Heather.
Oh, okay. That's not a surprise.
Yeah, we're in the, you know, yoga community down here in South Florida and met her through another mutual friend. I met Heather, she met me. Again, I'm sorry if I'm not on the conversation, but, we were both so drawn to each other and I had just gone through a severe tragedy. And we reconnected several times again and it's through her being part of community that she's now bringing me full back, you know, hopefully full circle and to be connected with all the people in particular that my daughter was surrounded by. So my daughter was a fixed figure down here in South Florida and her business was everything community based. And so, you know, to carry on in my daughter's legacy and in her name and furthering her visions, Heather, I think is going to help me get through there as I gain more and more strength. And I think, you know, when we take one hand and we take the next, we can soon form a very strong bond and know that we're not alone and feel the support of everybody. So through that's my little bit of how I intend to fulfill and live the rest of my life.
Powerful. Beautiful. You said you were drawn to Heather, not to diminish what you're up to. I'm just curious, like, about that draw. Like, what was it for you, or what is it that you feel about community that, like, draws you to someone or to some community? Like, what would you point to?
So we were at an event, and I had seen her, and I think more importantly was that what she was doing with the group of people she was with was inviting. And I'm a complete virtual. I speak to anybody. I go up to anybody. And I was just like, wow, I really admire what you guys are doing. And she was like, come sit with us, come join us. The next thing you know, boom, boom, boom. There we were. So it's the being open without walls. Of course, the nets to put up around us, but the walls we can kind of let down a little bit so that we can join forces with more people in community.
I love that. Like, let's not put the walls up. Let's be open without walls, but we'll have some safety nets just in case.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful,
you know, I mean, and we're both very, 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 you know, our personalities are similar. And I think, you know, you gotta be.
It was very beneficial. Very cool.
Awesome. Right.
We're both in the boat big group now.
Welcome back, everyone. Gina, welcome. You have to talk with Joe in the non-breakout room. What's present for you, Gina?
Great.
Experience been for you?
Happy to be here. Nice to meet everyone. David, you too. It was great. Joe actually, me and Joe go to the same gym. But he's-
Hey, what?
I was like, oh, what gym are you at? So he's at the Hollywood in Hewlett and I go to the Hollywood in Long Beach. So it's pretty funny, pretty small world.
This is the small world. That is incredible. Well, Joe, welcome back to the Morning Rush. Welcome forward. Jen, you had no idea you were connecting Joe and-
I didn't.
This is how the magic of this goes. We're at 8:30, so we're going to go into overtime. And I would love to hear anyone who wants to stick around and share what's coming up. But Christopher, Mariano, would you mind doing a countdown for us? So everyone, if you have to go on with your day, the official half hour of the Morning Rush is coming to a close. However, we do have the overtime, which usually lasts about 10 or 15 minutes. What I would ask, if you go out into the world today, maybe take on what Christopher and Mariano were saying about community. Like, it's not about me, it's not about you, it's about we, it's about how are we creating a space and an environment for others to show up and discover what they want to discover and be who they want to be. And with that, Christopher, Mariano, can you let us know when the overtime is going to start?
Let's do it in 3, 2, 1.
I think everyone should howl at the air or the moon or the wolves or something right now. Ben Curtis, hand is raised. I saw you were actually serendipitously maybe connected with Christopher and Mariano in the breakout rooms. And Ben is someone who really is a champion of men and men's work and all of that. So I'm really curious to hear what's present for you.
Thank you. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. We had a sound issue, so I got to just listen to the guys in our breakout room. But we had a call last night, and the most powerful thing for me here is, and Sammy put his finger on it, is scarcity versus abundance, right? So there's an opportunity here in the third stage of talking about divine masculine and healing the masculine and all of this. And I want to point out, where are we trying to compete with people who might be the very medicine we're looking for to connect us?
Mm.
So if there's someone—
Wait, say that again, say that again. I hate to interrupt, say that
yeah.
again.
Yeah, where are we competing with people who might be the very medicine we need?
Mm.
So in the masculine, there is the warrior, the discipline, the magi, the king, right? And there's not much energy in like community that we talk about there. So one of the most beautiful things, the reason I started Dude School, is for guys to come together and learn from each other. But what's happening here with the wolf pack is we're all becoming members of the wolf pack, no matter where we are, that we're taking men's work in the world just by being ourselves. And so one of the most— it's pretty much, I think it's the first time I've had the honor to speak to a men's group who's actually said, like, we're interested in working together, because so many of these things, I've got mine, rather than let's share, let's open this up together. How can we learn from each other? So it's been— I really want to acknowledge these two men and Maggie. There's an incredible woman who's also part of the wolf pack and driving this forward. They do walk the talk, and we are looking for how to collaborate. We all will be together at your Ironman in October in Florida. So I just want to share, like, where can we lean into those people who we feel may be competition? We could actually ask them, hey, what's working for you? And here's what's working for me. Can we help each other? So I wanted to plant that seed today. It's Friday. It's fun. Spreading the love. How can we help each other, especially those people who we may see as our biggest threat? They could have the medicine we need if we said, hey, would you want to talk or work together?
Mm.
What might be possible then? That almost— I'll tell you, I've been running and in men's groups for almost 10 years. That's never happened to me before.
Mm.
We're getting to meet these guys together. So I'm really grateful for that space. And I want to acknowledge them and each and every one of you for being here in a morning rush, in a space where we're actually all looking for how we can support each other. So thank you.
You know, it's so funny because there was a short thought for me this morning when I saw Ben in the room and I saw the wolf pack in the room, and I'm like, they kind of do the same thing. Is this like, am I treading on my friendship with Ben because they're here? And like all those thoughts started to go. And it's so true. Like a lot of times, yeah, I've got mine, I'll let you worry about yours, but how are we showing up in letting go of that ego or that attachment to our outcomes and really being about the bigger, greater cause, where Dude School and Wolfpack and Morning Rush and all of us can co-create and lift each other higher versus being in some kind of competitive thing. And Cynthia actually said in our breakout room, she said, we need to be open without walls and always have our own safety net. Like what takes care of us and nourishes us, but allowing— because I said, this is what I said. I said to her, I was like, she said, you know, Heather drew me in, or we drew ourselves to one another. And I said, what was it? And she just said, like, there was an openness, like, hey, we're excited about what you're doing. Like, and Heather was just like, yeah, come sit down. Like, come sit down at our table. Let's talk. Let's figure out where we can come together. So Heather, over to you. Tough red carpet for you to come into right now.
I mean, I feel honored and grateful, like David, as you know, to that, you know, the origin of this for my healing and my mending has always been, you know, it's not a doubt that I'm always in a room with the boys. In elementary school, we had to get in size order. I'm 43 years old. So every teacher, so I was in the back with the boys. Here we are. So now I get to be the cream and the Oreo cookie of putting dude school together with the wolf pack. Both groups have invited me to be the healthy, divine, feminine balance in my masculine and feminine, to call guys out and be that role. And to me, you know, it is God putting me in the rooms that I belong in, and that I get to bring it back to the source because I'm in integrity and say, hey, David and Ben, I'm not doing this without you. I couldn't, it's not going to happen any other way. And so here we are. And then we all get to just support and share, and whether I fly and heal and help, and, or if I'm on a screen here, like the Wizard of Oz, guiding all these men's groups with technology, whatever's affordable for everyone, I'm there. Jen can set up all our websites, and Jamal, we can support your charity. And, you know, when Mariano was like, oh, Ben, you know, I want to sign up and come to dude school this summer. I mean, I almost cried last night on the phone call. And I kid you not, I woke up this morning to a text from my friend Josh, who has a 3-app business he's expanding, sharing another men's retreat with me. God sending me this stuff while I'm sleeping. Just thanks to you guys, you know, it's helping me heal and understand my role in the world and my dharma. Like, who's my avatar client? When do we have that conversation, David? 6 months ago?
Mm-hmm.
4 months ago? And God is answering because I too have surrendered. Thank you, Dude School and the Morning Rush and Omni Thrive and the Wolf Pack. Here we go. It's party time.
Heather, can you talk about what you mean by surrender? And the reason why I ask is there was like my morning workout. Like there was a surrender that happened for me. And magical thing, like it was weird. I went for an hour and 15 minute run, and I came back right before this call to some text messages, and I was like, that's a pretty cool list of text messages, but I wasn't expecting them. And I think it's part of like what happened inside of me that other things show up. But I'm curious, like, how would you describe surrender?
So for me, surrender is giving up control, which causes a removal of any kind of suffering that's happening. We get attached to how something should be. You know, Tony calls it shitting all over yourself, which is shitting all over yourself, because you're not leaving space and wiggle room for how it's only about you and your ego and what you think and what you want and how you see yourself. And when you give all of that bullshit up, that's when the light comes. That's when the love comes in. That's when the abundance comes. And it really is about goodbye scarcity mentality. Hello, I am abundant and beautiful and talented, intelligent. And so for me, surrender is like, I can stand in and do mirror work and make my dance videos and go, wow, I'm going to attract all the right people and all the right things and all the right places. And I'm not in control about any of it, like zero things. And I'm a Scorpio who is very into intentional things, but now it's intention. It's not control. So just get it. It's my favorite Janet Jackson song, but now it's a joke because I don't want to be in charge. I want to be the Oreo and let you guys run everything and just tell me when I'm coming.
Heather, I have two quick questions, and I want to get back to Christopher and Mariano, but if you weren't watching, Jamal Smiles was like smiling and laughing, and I want you to maybe guess. What do you think? Was he thinking about Oreo cookies, or what would you say he was probably laughing and smiling about? Then we'll find out what he was actually laughing and smiling about, and then we're going to go to Christopher and Mariano. So over to you, Heather.
Yeah, I'm sure Jamal's just laughing because he's calling himself out, because he and I probably had that in common. And I know we're going through similar things with our moving. And so when God moves you, and you remove suffering, then you get to smile again. So he's what got the best smile ever. So Jamal was my guest, right? Were you calling yourself out?
Well, before he speaks, I think he's laughing about like that creepy guy on the counter behind him that's like looking over his shoulder. But that's my guess. Jamal, what's the answer?
That's a celebrity chef over there.
Speaking about wolves, you know, I got Gordon Ramsay over my shoulder, or I don't know who he is. But what I was laughing at is Nick messaged me out of the blue telling me, pay attention, smiles, because periodically what I'll do is I'll send somebody a message and tell them to pay attention, like Nick or Jen or somebody random. And now I'm like getting a taste of my own medicine. So I'm like, oh, that's what that feels like.
I love it. Pay attention, smiles. That's accountability happening behind the scenes on The Morning Rush in the chat. I love it. I love it. I love it. Christopher, Mariano, over to you guys. What, you know, what are some of the things that you would point, like, I think men's work and probably women's work and all the work we do sometimes is confronting, it's challenging. Some men aren't actually open to it. But what's on the other side of it? Like, what are some of the things you see men receiving inside of the programs that you guys are delivering?
Easy question. Where do we start? But just take a second to sit on that. You know, I would say it's transformation. If that would be one word that is definite, like. There's evidence of that, and that's why we continue to do it. If we've held retreats, and from the time that the person walked in the door and then the time that the person left, it's almost like a different character. And so, and that is a continuous development of, it's like a transformation of their perspective. And so once you change your perspective, you can't unsee that. So then it keeps it going in some way and towards that direction for a while. And sure, you can get back into some behavioral patterns that are, you know, maybe familiar to yourself, but there is, you always have that now, that new perspective sitting over your shoulder, like tapping you whenever you know you should be doing it differently, or you can be doing it. You'll feel like shame or guilt because you know that you have that perspective now, so it exists for you forever. Yeah. But the evidence is, you know, of that transformation from point A to point B, and that once that person has developed to a different or a positive change, it affects not just them individually, but then it affects the relationship with their children. It reflects the relationship with their spouse. It affects the relationship with their coworkers. And every single, from the cashier that they go to the grocery store on, and that begins to spread everywhere. And mm-hmm. So we've noticed this to be true and evident. Otherwise, we would have stopped this a long time ago because we've done so much of it, and we've seen results. So that's how I feel about the difference. You
know? To me, I always say it's the diet versus lifestyle. You know, a lot of men are like going through a hard time and they just want to get out of that hard time. They want to do that diet thing. Just give me that pill. Just give me that one thing that's going to stop this pain. And we're like, this is not a diet. You know, it's not like, you know, if you do this for 3 months, then everything's going to change. This is a lifestyle. You know, this is like you're going to change the whole way you live and the way you think and how you feel. And there's no turning back, because now when we open your eyes and show you what you're capable of doing, you're not going to want to go back, because now you're going to live with integrity. And I didn't even know what integrity was. I didn't know what the word integrity meant up until 3 years ago, you know? So that's how I see what we do here. It's a lifestyle change.
Beautiful. Yeah. It's like you may see something, and once you see something, you're never not going to see it again. Like it's like a whole new opening, but then awareness is what leads to the change if you commit to the change. However, that's a different conversation as well, as like the integrity conversation. Like, here's what I want to do. Here's what I say I'm going to do. Now let's see if you're going to do it. And that's the lifestyle. That's not just like a get quick fix diet or pill or anything like that. It's day in, day out. And, you know, pay attention, smiles. Smiles, what would you say? Like, if everybody wanted something day in and day out, like, what should they do in the morning?
Well, in the mornings, you know, from 8 to 8:30, come on to The Morning Rush, you know. It's where you come. That's where you learn about integrity. That's where you learn about being your word. That's where you learn about your dharma. That's where you learn about stepping into your power. It's where you see Sammy fist pumping. You know, everything that you could ever ask for is on this call. Mondays through Fridays, 8 to 8:30, starts at the overtime at 8:30 for another 10 to 12 minutes.
I love it. I love just pushing the button, like calling Jamal in. Gina, what's present for you this morning? I know that you probably didn't know necessarily exactly what you were getting into, and Jen extended a gracious invite. I'm just curious, anything that's on your mind or your heart, or what opened up in this conversation?
No, I really wasn't sure what to expect, but Jen asked me to join it. And honestly, you guys all seem very great. Lot of good insight. I'm an entrepreneur myself. I teach tennis for a living. I go down half the year to Florida. I work at a country club there in Boca Raton. And then I come back half the year here. And I'm an independent contractor. I teach privately. You know, I go to people's houses and go to the park. So my business is very, very face-to-face and personable. And that's how I like to keep it. I've been doing this on my own for about 5 years, and my business is just keeps growing. I keep getting new clients every year, and all my clients, seem to come back, and they really like working with me. And I work with kids, I work with adults. So I have that, I have a broad, all ages of fun. And I'm very athletic. I've done sports my whole life, and I think it's really shaped who I am as a person, and it's really taught me a lot over my years, adversity, teamwork, and, love, and all of it. So really excited to be here. I think this is something I'd really like to continue doing, and I think it would help my business as opposed to other businesses as well. I really, really like it.
Awesome. Awesome. So good to have you here. So many interesting connections for you already. Joe in the gym just happened to be on this call, and then right. Heather's already saying, like, when are you getting in Jen's suitcase to come down and visit us? Because Heather is in the Del Rey. I'm going to be biking tomorrow morning, probably about 4 a.m. And there's a whole bunch of connectivity. So this is awesome. Good to have you here, Gina. And anytime you want to show up.
Thank you, David.
Jen told me she's going next week. Is that true? There's a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes here. Sammy, we're going to close this out in just a minute. But another comment, and if anybody else wants to comment or ask maybe Christopher or Mariano something about what they're up to. And guys, I don't know if there's a link or something that you share just for people to connect with you or to find out more information. Feel free to throw that in the chat. And obviously you guys are part of the Morning Rush community now on WhatsApp as well. Sammy, over to you, brother. What's happening?
You know, the wolf pack reminds me of the wolves in the movie Twilight, and that's one of my, that's one of my shameful vices, that I actually like that movie. It's a ridiculous acting, and the writing is, but the wolves, man, that's the best part of the movie, right? The movie series. When times are tough, the leaders come out, right? When do the Native American tribe, they start turning to wolves, is when the vampires show up. That's when they start turning to wolves. That's when they start phasing into wolves. So when the times are tough, the leaders come out, and we see them over here. And then leaders attract other leaders, and they work together. And that's why I'm just so honored to be a part of this leadership group.
I love it. When tough times come, leaders show up. They're the ones who are called upon, and we see who the leaders are in some of those moments as well. Sammy, I was thinking about the movie Hangover, and we just added another one to the wolf pack. That's a fun analogy as well. All right, Christopher Mariano, come on in.
Yeah, I got one thing I was wanting to share for you, David, is that, we struggled with, that ego and wanting 1,000 members as well, right? And we had a conversation with our brothers the other night at the dinner table, and what one of them said was very profound, and he said, if we had 1,000 people of the wrong type, it would not be good, right? Mm-hmm. So what we have is, it's better to have 10 of the right type of people.
Sorry about that.
we got the wolves over here just getting out. Sorry about that.
The wolves are coming. Are we okay? We've got the wolf. Joe Cohen, what's going on, my friend? Good to see you. Long time, you know, what's happening?
Yeah, I'm sorry that I'm at the gym, everyone. It's great being here. It's my first time here since you first started, so it's been a long time. Anyway, I just want to say, David, I'm very impressed with what you created. This is a great group. I could tell I'm surrounded by leaders. I love the energy. I love the language that people are using. And I'm looking forward to participating in more morning rushes. Hopefully I can get my act together and wake up earlier and get to the gym earlier so I can be at home in front of my laptop to join.
That would be great. You can join from the gym where you want. Don't call it a comeback, like LL said.
Thanks for having me. And it's nice to virtually meet everyone.
Yes, awesome to be here. Christopher Mariano, any final thoughts or words or anyone else want to share before we wrap up? We went a little bit over the 8:45 mark, but I think it was worthwhile.
My final word, believe in yourself, man. Just get out of your own way and believe in yourselves, because you can do whatever you want to do. You just have to believe in yourself.
Mic drop, everyone. Believe in yourself. And I think the message around community, just have that be present as well. Like, it's not about me, it's about we, and how do we bring that out into the world? Because that's what this heart-centered community is all about, is not just about bringing it here, but also each and every moment, each and every day, we're lifting it higher and bringing it out to others. Because there's other people out there who are looking for what you have and looking for what we have, and we want to share that. So, all right, everyone. Have a great Friday, a great weekend, and we'll see you all very soon.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.